Hello, everybody. Welcome to the Don Ellis Gatlin Show. That's me. And we're going to kick things off with a great song from a great group in country music for a long, long time. That group is called Shenandoah. And this is The Church on a Cumberland Road. Glad you're here tonight. Get ready for an amazing musical experience, because I got my good buddy, one of the best singer-songwriters in this town has ever known, and he's here tonight as our special guest. I'm talking about Mr. Steve Dean. Yes. Unbelievable. Actually, I'll tell you what, going back to the very beginning, Steve,
okay.
You were someone I admired when I wasn't even living in Nashville. You were a young pup. You came to town very, very young. And you got off to an amazing start writing hit songs right off the bat. And I was a few years younger, just a few. Yep. And I was in Pennsylvania playing your songs. And I hadn't even met you yet. We were doing your number one songs. My brother and I were playing in Pennsylvania and Ohio. And I said, man, this Steve Dean is on all my favorite artists. And this is the guy right here, folks. I'm so honored and so blessed to get to not only get to know you, but we've been friends for a long time. And we've got to write songs together. It's been a great thrill for me. And we're going to start things off. Before we even get into everything, I think we should start off with a number one song.
Okay.
Just get the ball rolling.
Let's do it.
Who'd you write this number one song for?
George Strait.
Yeah, Mr. George Strait, folks. This song, Steve Dean wrote, number one song in the nation.
Yes, sir.
And see if y'all remember this song, a little roundabout way.
far as all my friends can tell, I took her leaving. Well, that's kinda right, 'cause when I'm out with them, I don't let her memory ruin night. For the most part, I'm okay, but I still miss her in a roundabout way. Around about the time that midnight rolls around, yeah, that's around about the time my tears start falling down. 'Cause she's not around, I come unwound, and my heart breaks, 'cause I still miss her in a roundabout way. Well, I no longer sit at home for hours by the phone, wishing she would call. Just the other day, I took her smiling face down off the wall. I've come a long, long way, but I still miss her. Start falling down, 'cause she's not around, I come unwound, my heart breaks, 'cause I still miss her in a roundabout way. She's not around, I come unwound, my heart breaks, 'cause I still miss her in a roundabout way. 'Cause I still miss her in a roundabout way.
Take it out, boys. Steve Whoa. Dean in the house.
Thank you, man.
Oh my gosh, number one song. Honestly, I gotta tell you right off the bat, Steve, that's that album that that's on is one of Jay and I's absolute favorite country albums of all time. I think it's a masterpiece.
Well, thank you, man.
And you're part of that masterpiece.
Thank you.
That's an incredible album. How'd this all get started? I know you're from Little Rock.
I'm from Little Rock, Arkansas. I moved over here in 1980.
Wow.
Yeah.
I don't think I knew that.
Yeah. And I actually got in the business in 1982.
There you go.
With when I walked into Tom Collins' office.
Legend.
Yes, sir. He was. He gave me my start, really. So I owe a lot to Tom Collins. And
for people that do not know who Tom Collins is, he was absolutely the biggest independent publisher. On top of that, top producer for Barbara Mandrell, Ronnie Millsap, Sylvia.
Steve Warner,
a whole bunch of artists throughout his career. So that's
he was a great guy
we're talking about.
And he's awesome.
So you come to town, he says, I like what you're doing, and you start writing songs for his company, which is a big deal, folks. That's a very big deal. A publishing deal is just about as hard to get as a record deal. It's whatever all these songwriters that come to Nashville dream of coming down here and getting that break where they can get paid to write their songs.
Yeah.
And so the first cut, I do believe, the first big cut I do believe you had was actually with two of my heroes, Steve Warner and Ronnie Millsap. Am I correct?
That's right.
That was like, what a good start, Steve.
Yeah. Actually, Sylvia was my very first.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Yeah, in 1982. But Ronnie cut Don't Your Memory Ever Sleep at Night in 1982.
Great song.
And then it wasn't released as a single on Ronnie, but Steve Warner cut it in March of 83, and it became my first single.
And that is a running theme you'll hear tonight, folks, on the show. Steve Dean is one of those rare writers that has had multiple cuts with the same song. And that's always a mark of a great song. Like, sometimes you get lucky with an artist that matches up perfect, but when it matches up with everybody, all the greats, I think of a song that you wrote for Conway Twitty, Hendersonville's own.
Yes.
And then you turn around, just showing off, and Waylon Jennings does the same song. I mean, come on, guys. people dream of just
truthfully
meeting those people.
Truthfully, I was pinching myself about that because it was unreal.
But it's a great song, too. Shadow of a Distant Friend.
Shadow of a Distant Friend.
You're not doing that one tonight.
No.
But you are going to do a song. I'm going to look at your cheat sheet.
Yeah.
You're doing a song. Oh, this is a great song. This is another double. This is another double.
Yes, it is.
The song Steve's going to do right now is a song that was recorded by Craig Morgan.
Yes.
But was a hit for Mr. Joe Nichols.
Right. And Joe wrote it with us.
Oh, he's a co-writer on this song.
Yeah, as Will Nance and Joe.
Oh, fantastic.
Yeah.
What is it called, Steve Dean?
Well, the thing about this I need to talk about,
too,
is this song is got one chord in it, Don.
I remember when this happened. This was a big deal in Nashville. You're the first one to have a hit with one chord.
Well, the thing is, too, if you, as musicians know, and I was looking at these guys' charts, and it was the same as the one in the studio, it's the intro is 1-1-1-1. Verse... 1-1-1-1. You get the picture, and then that's right. And then the chorus was 1-1-1-1, and the bridge.
1-1-1-1.
Right. So, this is a lot of fun. This is I always think of this song as just a lot of fun. You know, it's really kind of doesn't mean much, but everybody seems to like it. So
it makes people happy.
It makes them happy. I've closed a lot of shows with this song,
too. It's a happy song written by Mr. Steve Dean in the house, our special guest on the Don Ellis Gatlin Show, and it sounds something like this.
Well, I hit the snooze when the alarm clock rang. Laying there doing that sleepyhead thing. Out my window a bird is spreading his wings. Cheap chirp doing that singing thing I do when I first get up. Is the coffee thing in my favorite cup. Two gets me going, got things to do. Let me tell you a thing or two. Everything's a thing if you know what I mean. You can't do nothing cause there's no such thing. Some things are big, some things are small. Some mean a lot, some nothing at all. It's all laid out in the scheme of things. No matter what it is, everything's a thing.
Are you with me so far?
Well, it's off to work in my old Mustang. Doing that bumper to bumper thing. Up ahead a ring, a ling, ding, ding. Some guy's doing that cell phone thing. Is the lights turn green? He ain't doing that driving thing. The thing is about all this. The texting thing and driving don't mix. Everything's a thing if you know what I mean. Can't do nothing cause you don't search me. some ain't a lot, some nothing at all. It's all laid out in the scheme of things. No matter what it is, everything's a thing. Well, if you think this song ain't worth humming, you got another thing coming. Everything's a thing, if you know what I mean. You can't do nothing, cause there's no such thing. Some things are big, some things are small. Some ain't a lot, some nothing at all. It's all laid out in the scheme of things. No matter what it is, everything. Well, everything's a thing.
Everything, yeah.
You gotta do your thing. Well, everything's a thing.
That is awesome. Mm. Oh, if you just joined us, it's the Don Ellis Gatlin Show. You're watching on YouTube. We need everyone out there to subscribe to the show. We're bringing great, great guests like Steve Dean every week, folks. And we need you to subscribe to the Don Ellis Gatlin Show. Well,
like and subscribe.
What's that? Like and subscribe. Like and subscribe. Thank you. Speaking of that, that's my son Austin behind the cameras tonight, Austin Gatlin. And we got John Newton running sound, doing all kind of crazy things.
Yay!
Folks, I always want to tell you, this guy is the best in the biz. If you need him, I'll let you borrow him for maybe one or two nights. But you got to bring him back. Give us a call if you need this guy for a couple of days. He can do anything behind the scenes. He's the best. Also, we're so glad to be here. We missed Jarrett this week. He's out there doing some other things. Because everything's a thing.
Everything.
If you know what I mean. And I'll tell you what, we have an amazing band. How about a hand for the band?
Woo! Yes, the band.
Jay Smith on that fiddle, David Abdo on that bass, Josh Berkheimer on the drums, Tony Hahn on guitar. Now, Steve, you have done a lot of great things in music for a long, long time. You made your own great recordings too. You've done in solo records. You've done in trio form, duo form.
Yeah.
You've worked with a lot of different people, and you've done a lot of great work. This new project that you've been working on is very, very, I think, special. Maybe one of the most special things that you've been a part of.
It's been a life changer.
It's really, really incredible.
What we're talking about is I co-founded a nonprofit called Freedom Sings USA with Don Goodman.
Love Don.
And yeah, I do too. And a lady named Bobby Standifer.
I don't like her.
Out of Chattanooga.
I'm totally kidding. Just totally kidding.
You don't know her.
I'm just totally kidding.
She's she lives in Chattanooga. That's where we actually formed this company, was in Chattanooga. And so we go, Don and I, back before the virus hit, we were traveling across the Mont Eagle every Wednesday morning, bright and early, like we had to be down there for a class at 9 o'clock Eastern time. So a couple hour drive. But anyway, we've been doing this all on Zoom since COVID has happened.
Since the virus,
This has been a great thing for veterans, and veterans need this because they have got a lot of stuff inside them that they've seen stuff they're not that nobody's supposed to see. So it's a real privilege and an honor for me to be able to do this. I was down in Little Rock visiting my father, and I went to church with him on a Sunday, and there's a friend of his named Bruce Weston. And Bruce was a Vietnam War photographer. So this man was on the front lines. He had a pistol on his hip, but he had a camera, and that was his job, was to take pictures. So I asked Bruce, I said, Bruce, I've gotten this new company going, and I would like for you to tell your story to us so we can write your story in a song if you'd like to. He said, let me think about that. So I got home probably about Wednesday of that week. He called me and said, Steve, I think I want to do this. So this song is called We Shot the Pictures.
They're literally taking the words from the soldiers and turning it into a wonderful song.
Don Goodman
tells their story.
Don Goodman is he interviews the veterans, and we get them to tell their whole story, and then we start pulling the lines out. Don's a master at that, pulling the lines out then, and he forms it into a lyric.
Right.
And then I put the music.
Always been a great lyricist.
Oh, he's a great lyricist. Always. Yeah. Always great. Anyway.
This is wonderful, Steve.
Yeah.
This is one of the songs from one of the soldiers.
This is about Bruce Wesson. It's his song. It's his story, and we put it to this song.
Steve Dean, everybody. Awesome.
The film went back from Cameron Bay in a classified bag to the USA, but the negatives stay in my mind. I've looked at them a million times. We shot the pictures, they shot the guns. Never belonged, just tagged along. Didn't fit in, wasn't one of them. They were fighting to keep each other alive. I was a 1LT with the Nikon 35. We shot the pictures, they shot the gun. It ain't all in black and white. Blood runs red in the middle of the night. There's a place to hide, but no escape. Froze time in a hell of a place. The gallery of war. The late, great 68. We shot the picture, they shot the gun. While the survivors of a firefight are digging in for a long night, we fly out with the wounded and dead. Fight with guilt in a warm, dry bed. We shot the picture, they shot the gun. It ain't all in black and white. The blood runs red in the middle of the night. There's a place to hide, but no escape. We froze time in a hell of a place. The gallery of war. The late, great 68. We shot the picture, they shot the gun. I made a deal with the prayers I prayed. If I live through this, I'll pay it back one day. When people walk through these halls, they'll see the truth there on display. The orphans, the heroes, the soldiers and the pain won't be left in the jungle, standing in the rain. No, it ain't all in black and white. The blood runs red in the middle of the night. There's a place to hide, but no escape. We froze time in a hell of a place. The gallery of war. The late, great 68. Shot the picture, they shot the gun. Oh. We shot the picture.
Oh yeah. Steve Dean.
Hey.
Now I tell you what, I want to say before we go any further, how important this guy right here has been to my career. As I said at the beginning of the show, I was already a fan. Then I came down to Nashville, got lucky enough. The very first song that we ever wrote together, I don't know if you remember this, there was a group called 12 Gauge, which became Emerson Drive. And we wrote their first single.
That's right.
And that was the first song we ever wrote together. Went to number 11 in Canada, went to number 82 with an anchor in America. They weren't loved yet in America, but they came around. But that was our first song. We were batting 1,000.
Yes, we were.
And then that was my first song I'd written for another artist, you know, at that point. Yeah. I'm pretty sure it's the first one. Then, like, literally a month later, we got together with our dear friend, Billy Montana, and we were all digging the song. What If God Was One of Us. I'll never forget that.
Yeah.
We were over at Tom Collins at your office.
That's right.
And we wrote a song called Last Love in This Town, which became a song on Ricochet's album. Tony's mom's favorites. You like them too.
I love Ricochet, yeah.
Shout out to Julie. Shout out to Julie. She's a big Ricochet fan. And that was a big thrill. But even before that, we were writing, and the biggest song of my career I wrote with Billy Montana and this guy right here, Mr. Steve Dean, for Daryl and Don Ellis.
Right.
That's my brother and I. No Sir.
No Sir.
And so that got me all over the world. That got me playing all over America. And just really was a game changer for my career. And then we go further than that, even into Savannah Jack's music. Steve's been there for all of that. Mm. Multiple songs on multiple Savannah Jack albums. Steve has been my co-writer. And some of my favorite songs, some of our fans' favorite songs, Steve, you don't even know this, but an absolute fan favorite, and these guys can testify on this one, is Don't Waste Your Pretty on Him.
Oh, yeah.
And that's one of the absolute favorites of our fans. They always requested that song. And we almost got that cut by Darius Rucker. We came really close.
I didn't even know
you
that.
You didn't even know that. We did.
That's probably good.
Really
that I
close.
Didn't know.
I know. I hate to go, hey, I remember Sean Kemp called me and with a song I wrote with Sean. He goes, hey, man, you know, the guy with the big hat's cutting our song. George Strait's cutting our song.
Oh, wow.
And I was like, not George Strait, Garth Brooks. What am I talking about?
Oh, that big hat.
Even bigger.
Yeah.
And I go, Garth Brooks looks like he's cutting our song, man. I'm like, oh my gosh. And then he goes, oh, he went with something else. I'm like, I don't even want to know until that thing is recorded. When do you get comfortable with it?
Well, I used to always say, it ain't final till it's final.
Yes. Like you literally see it in the store.
Right.
Yeah, because it's like you've had so many songs recorded. Was there a artist that you always wanted to like have record your song and it happened, or is there a favorite recording that do you have any favorites? Like
well,
as you say,
I mean George Strait.
That's yeah.
I always wanted Alabama. Come on, I always loved Alabama.
That's is that what we're doing next?
We're
too?
Doing that next. What a segue!
What amazing! It's a great segue. Now this song, Alabama, such an unbelievably huge group for everybody. Steve, we talked about this many times. When they first came to town and they came out with their first albums, you know, they were a game changer because they brought that Southern rock. They brought that energy that we were kind of missing. We didn't really have anybody doing that on a big level like that. Mm-hmm. And it was so wonderful. And then, of course, you write a song that's a part of that whole Alabama anthem, like what they stand for. And this song was perfect for them. Went all the way to number one again.
Yes, sir.
A song called Southern Star, written by this guy right here, Mr. Steve Dean. Goes like this.
Oh, Southern Star, how I wish you would shine and show me the way to get home. Well, I'm blue-collar branded and stuck in a mill. Hard work is a way of life for me. I'm too young to live like I'm over the hill, and too old to be wild and free. Oh, my heart is homeward bound. I'm rolling with a feeling and I can't slow down. I need a guiding light shining down to lead me through the night. Oh, Southern Star, how I wish you would shine and show me the way to get home.
Hey. Tell Tony.
Hey, my DJ friend, won't you play me one more song? Let my mind just go and drift away. We all have a dream and a place where we belong. Somewhere we can go and escape. Oh, my heart is overbound. I'm rolling with the feeling and I can't slow down. Shining down to lead me through the night. Oh, Southern Star, how I wish you would shine. Show show me the way to get home.
Sing.
Oh, Southern Star, how I wish you would shine. Show me the way to get home.
Come on.
Star, how I wish you would shine and show me the way to get home.
Yeah, man.
Yeah. Southern Star. Mm. Now, I noticed something in the song. There's a verse that's different than what Alabama did. And I noticed that happens to on hit songs a songwriter will write. Tell us the story on that, because that verse is different you did.
Yeah, it is different. And usually when I'm playing it out in places that it's with my trio, I'm in a trio called Hits and Grins.
Right, right, and, yes. Tell everybody about that.
Hits and Grins? Oh, tell everybody about Hits and Grins.
Because we'll be back out on the road again someday.
Yeah, right. So Hits and Grins is Bill White and Victoria Veneer and me. And so Bill's a comedian. And so I do the original version of the way we wrote it, of Southern Star.
Stephen Stills is in the original.
That's right. And so so that Bill has something to, you know, he is part of the shtick, but he'll say, now, why did Alabama not want to sing about Stephen Stills?
I don't know.
Well, because he was a rock star back in 1985.
Right.
Now Stephen Stills or the Crosby, Stills and Nash probably is more country than country.
Yes, but that's three-part harmony, like Alabama's three-part harmony.
Exactly. Yeah.
Exactly. You know.
So when Zach Brown records this song,
there you go.
Then he'll do the original version.
Is that going to happen?
I don't know.
Let's throw it out there.
Let's
throw it out there, Zach Brown. It's time for you to do Southern Star. I tell you what, he does anything he covers really great. That's a really great show.
No,
Zach Brown.
Yeah,
I remember seeing him doing the Devil Went Down to Georgia.
Oh.
They put costumes on and all kind of crazy stuff.
Wow.
All kind of great stuff. Now, we're moving on to look at my cheat sheet again. Oh yeah. We're moving on to another number one.
Yes.
Now, I mentioned other people that I admired so much that you've written songs that we're not going to cover tonight. I want to get those in there because it's a great song. We mentioned Barbara Mandrell. I mean, she was, when I was a little boy, she had her own show.
She did.
And you were writing some of her biggest hits during that period of the show and on. And then, but Reba McEntire.
Oh, Lord.
I mean, this guy right here is a number one song for Miss Reba.
Yes.
And it's that's a great song, too.
Thank you.
I remember seeing her in concert doing that song. It's a great live version,
it's
too.
It's a great live version.
It's the song we're talking about is Walk On.
Yes.
Steve's not doing that one tonight unless we twist his arm. But no. but that's another one of his number ones that he can't get to tonight because he's got other ones like this song, which went number one for the Oak Ridge Boys.
Correct.
And we had their kids in here, Dwayne Allen's grandkids in here.
That's awesome.
And his daughter, they're called Rockland Road, and they are incredible.
Oh, I've heard of them.
They are absolutely incredible vocal group.
That's where their offices used to be on Rockland Road.
Right. And Paul Martin is married to Dwayne Allen's daughter.
Okay.
And he was formerly in Exile and Marty Stewart Band, mm-hmm. and they are absolutely incredible.
That's awesome.
But we're going all the way full circle.
Cool.
Steve wrote this song. You said you ran into...
Well, I was at a Country Weekly Christmas party several years ago.
Yeah.
I was there with the Roys, actually. Lee and
Roy. Oh, yes.
I was with them. And I saw Dwayne standing over there, and I thought, I got to go say hi to Dwayne. He probably won't remember me, but I'm going to go say hi to him anyway. So I go over there. And I stick my hand out, and he goes, Steve, thanks for the song.
Awesome.
And I was just like, whoa.
Man, that, Oak Ridge Boys are some of the finest ambassadors to country music, and just the way they treat people and their show and the way they treat the opening acts, and they appreciate the great songs given to great writers like yourself.
Another cool thing about this, too, was I was down doing a show in Port St. Joe, Florida, doing a songwriters festival down there, and I was presented a Million Air Award for this song.
Yes!
Took about yes. 20 years to get it, but finally we got it.
Hey, it's a big old number one. I love this song. Again, it's yes. one of those ones
yep.
that my brother and I would sing, I you know, before I even met you. And I love it. Takes a little rain to make love grow.
Correct.
Number one.
Sometimes we're friends, sometimes we're strangers, and though there are tears, there's always love. It hurts when you cry from words thrown in anger. Warm feelings run deep, but that's not enough. It takes a little rain to make love grow. It's the heartache and the pain that makes a real heart show, where the sun always shines. There's a desert below. It takes a little rain to make love grow. Hearts disagree, and then they grow closer. Honesty wins when it's someone you trust. Forever takes time. True love never over. It's filled with new starts. Just look at us. It takes a little rain to make love grow. It's a heartache and the pain that makes a real heart show, where the sun always shines. There's a desert below. It takes a little rain to make love grow. It takes a little rain. To make love grow.
Boys, written by Mr. Steve
Thank
Dean.
You boys.
Unbelievable. If you just joined us, you're watching the Don Ellis Gatlin Show. That's me. So honored to be here doing this incredible music with my amazing bandmates.
Amazing band.
Unbelievable.
I would say
unbelievable.
Amazing.
Unbelievable. And folks, real quick plug. Please, again, Don Ellis Gatlin Show. Please subscribe and like. Please. Like and subscribe.
That's how we get fed.
That's how we get fed, folks. And also, if you'd like to know where Savannah Jack's playing in the future, when we go back on the road someday again, SavannahJackBand.com has our tour dates. If you want to see myself and Tony with the Kenny Rogers Band, we've got concerts coming up too. Check out Kenny Rogers Band. Tom Petty.com. I think I got all that stuff covered.
I think you did. Could I throw mine out there, too?
Oh, that's, well, that's what we're here for.
Freedom Sings USA.
Absolutely.
I meant to do that earlier, but check us out at freedomsingsusa.org. And you can check our website out and see what we're doing.
Absolutely.
Thank you.
We'll post those links on the comment section, too, so people can click on it.
Oh, okay.
Yes, right, absolutely.
Thank you.
Steve.
Yes, sir.
You're one of those rare writers who, like I said, wrote number one songs in the 80s, number one songs in the 90s, number one songs in the 2000s, number one song in the 2010s decade, all these decades. What for you has been the biggest adjustment, shift in the musical sounds of Nashville and country music? Like, because you've been there for all of it, yeah. So which is rare. You know, anything else? Because we have a lot of musicians and writers that watch the show, so it's like, any advice or kind of, well, what's the main thing you've noticed that's changed in the town?
I just noticed that it's getting a lot younger.
Well, yes.
That, I mean, if that happens, though, that's just the way it is. That's the natural thing. I'm staying in the flow, man. I'm doing the very best that I can.
We've had guests on the show that didn't even know I knew you and said, well, I got a great co-write coming up with Steve Dean, yeah. Like Ali Colleen.
Oh, yeah.
I'm writing with Steve. I go, Steve's my buddy.
Yeah.
You know, so that's one thing. You're writing with the new artist.
I am writing the new artist.
Yeah.
And they're calling me, which I appreciate that. Keep calling.
Well, they like songs getting recorded too, Steve.
Well, I mean, but I just really appreciate the fact that they do call me. And that, you know, we're digging in and we're still swinging for the fences. You know.
Absolutely. Well, I know in 2007, we got together with my bandmate at the time, Mr. Mike Uvula, and we wrote Something's Wrong in Vegas.
That's right.
That song, Kenny Love, recorded on his Greatest Hits 50th Anniversary album. Mm-hmm. And again, another important part of my life. He called me in the studio, you know, because he loved my voice. Mm-hmm. He loved that song. He recorded one of two songs, new songs he recorded for that album. What an honor.
Yeah.
That got us out on the road touring with Kenny Rogers all over the world, man. Because of that song. So thank you again, Steve.
Well, no, thank you.
Appreciate it very much. And that was in 2007. That was in that decade. So you've always adjusted. And like you can work, you can write with anybody, and you can make your music work for any artist in any genre in any decade, which is very rare.
I'm having a blast doing it.
It's too unbelievable.
I mean, it's the same thing, only different.
That's right. Well, this is an example. This is one of your songs. This went number one. I do believe. Do you remember what year this song went number one?
In 2007.
Well, same year as Vegas.
Right.
This was a song that Steve wrote in 2007 that went all the way to number one. And folks, you can count on your hand how many writers had a number one song in 1985, and then in 2007 had a number. It looks like this. He looks like there's an impot. Were you 12 when you came to town, Steve? Jeez, maybe like you never changed. You look the same.
Well, thank you.
Seriously.
Actually, Rodney Atkins was a writer on the song too, and Brian White as well.
Which is another thing that I've noticed. That, do you think it's more of that's going on? The writing with the artists.
Well, see,
more than ever.
I've made a career out of that, really.
I know you have.
I mean, I've written with a lot of artists like yourself. I mean, and you know, No Sir, and
yeah,
Craig Morgan, written with him, and Rodney, and
you mentioned Joe Nichols.
Joe Nichols. Oh yeah, I wrote a bunch with Joe.
Absolutely.
I hadn't seen Joe in a while, but last time I saw him, he nearly broke my neck squeezing me so tight.
Yeah,
I hadn't seen him in a while.
You wrote I remember that song that I love that you wrote with Billy Montana for his album. I've been saving it up for Saturday night.
Yeah.
That is such a great song. Well, that's a great tune.
Well, thank you, man.
And that's on Billy's album.
It is on Billy's album.
Yeah. Yep. But this is 2007, number one. Number one again. Rodney Atkins. Did I say it right?
Atkins.
Steve Dean. Go something like this.
Driving through town, just my boy and me, with a happy meal in his boots to see, knowing that he couldn't have the toy till his nuggets were gone. A green traffic light turned straight to red. I hit my brakes, mumbled under my breath. His fries went flying and his orange drink covered his lap. Then my four-year-old said a four-letter word, started with S, and I was concerned. And I said, son, now where'd you learn to talk like that? said, I've been watching you, Dad, ain't that cool? I'm your buckaroo, I wanna be like you, and eat all my food, and grow as tall as you are. We got cowboy boots and camo pants, yeah, we're just alike, hey, hey, we, Dad, I wanna do everything you do, 'cause I've been watching you. We got back home and I went to the barn. I bowed my head and I prayed real hard. Said, Lord, please help me help my stupid self. And this side of bedtime later that night, turning on my son Scooby-Doo nightlight, he crawled out of bed and he got down on his knees. He closed his little eyes, folded his little hands, spoke to God like he was talking to a friend. I said, son, where'd you learn to pray like that? Dad, ain't that cool? Well, I'm your buckaroo, I wanna be like you, and eat all my food, and grow as tall as you are. We like fixing things and holding mama's hand, yeah, we're just alike, hey, ain't we, Dad? I wanna do everything you do, 'cause I've been watching. Him in a hug and said, my little boy is a growing up. And he said, but when I'm big, I'll still know what to do. 'Cause I've been watching you, Dad, ain't that cool? I'm your buckaroo, I wanna be like you, and eat all my food, and grow as tall as you are. Then I'll be strong as soup. Man, we'll be just alike, hey, won't we, Dad? When I can do everything you do, 'cause I've been watching you. Hey, hey. Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Yes, you know what popped in my head?
What?
Just popped in my head, another one of your hit songs. This was number one, it was pretty darn close. Trade the Fast Lane for Country Road. Do you remember any of that one?
Yeah.
Can you play just a little bit of that for us? This is not in the show, but this is a big, big hit for Barbara Mandrell. Always loved Steve's version of this.
Yeah, you know, yeah.
Do you mind? This is not in the show, but.
I haven't played it in a while. Let's see if we can do it.
I got you back.
Okay. There's an 8-lane highway out in L.A. headed nowhere.
Yeah.
Day is a rat race. They're fighting for first place. It's like a nightmare. Yeah. It's a life of mass confusion. It's a heavy load. I'm ready to trade the fast lane for a country road.
Sing the chorus.
Come on and turn for the better. It's been a long, hard ride. This can't go on forever. I need a Sunday drive. I'd love to get behind the wheel before I lose control and trade the fast lane for a country road.
Another big hit from Barbara Mandrell, written by Steve Dean. That just popped in my head. I always loved that song. And again, another moment. Again, this is more recent, 2012. I got a song recorded by absolute one of my top heroes, Ronnie Millsap. Wrote that again with Mr. Steve Dean. A big moment in my life.
Wasn't that a great thing, man?
Unbelievable.
It was Mike Uvula's first cut.
Mike Uvula, absolutely.
And it was and
Mike, if you're watching.
Yeah, Mike. And my Ronnie Millsap, Don't You Remember It Sleep at Night, was my first Ronnie Millsap cut.
And that was my first Ronnie Millsap cut.
So we all had first Ronnie
Millsap. It's very, very, and how about the full circle? That Millsap in 1982, three was the first one?
82. October of 82, they recorded.
That's what I'm talking about, Steve Dean, how he's been writing great. 1982, song for Millsap. 2012, song for Millsap. Come on, that's amazing, Steve. That's freaking great. Now, at the end of every show, we do an influence. But guys, I have another pulling something from left field. One more song from left field. We had a request from our folks watching for that song. I had to bring it up. Don't Waste Your Pretty on Him. Any way we could pull that out? A little Don't Waste Your Pretty, guys. Everybody cool?
Stay
with me.
I'm staying with you. I got to grab me a little.
This is a song I wrote with Steve and Mike Uvula. This is one of our fans' favorite songs. It was on the Savannah Jack 2014 album, right? Yes. This is on our 2014 album. Yes. It really was. It goes like this. Special Requests. It's on iTunes. It is. And Spotify.
Don't waste your pretty on him. He'll play a game that you just can't win. He's not your lover, he's not your friend. Don't waste your pretty on him. Don't give your love away. Change your mind for your heart's sake. Tell him goodbye before it's too late. Don't give your love away. All I wanna do is love you, baby, the way you should be loved. It's my wish to give you everything you've been dreaming of. Don't waste your pretty on him. When you've been crying, where's he been? He only hurt you again and again. Don't waste your pretty on him. Jay Smith! On him. He'll play a game that you just can't win. He's not your lover, he's not your friend. Don't waste your pretty on him. Oh, I tell you again and again, don't waste your pretty on him.
Great job, guys. Great job. Again, folks, our special, special guests. I know y'all out there had to enjoy the show tonight. Steve, unbelievable music.
Thanks for having me,
unbelievable
man.
Stories, great stuff.
Thank you for playing. And
going back to your biggest influence,
yeah.
This group is the greatest.
Oh, yeah.
And I'm so glad you picked this group. Your biggest influence is the...
Beatles.
The Beatles.
Beatles.
Now, this is a cool song that you picked of all the Beatles songs. What made you go with this one? Just curious.
You know, I've liked this song the very first time I heard it and learned how to play it somewhat, you know, back when I was first learning how to play guitar, you know.
Right.
So, and then I've also just been kind of collecting some sheet music lately, the Beatles songs that I really liked, and that I luckily found She's a Woman. I didn't know
She's a Woman.
Had a sheet music of that one, but they do.
Well, Steve, Steve's going to take you out with a Beatle, absolutely wonderful Beatles song. Steve Dean, everybody, thank you again. Thank you, a woman. Thank you all for watching. It goes like this.
My love don't give me presents. I know that she's no peasant. Only ever have to give me love forever and forever. My love don't give me presents. Turn me on when I get lonely. People tell me that she's only fooling. I know she isn't. The eye. She hates to see me cry. She is happy just to hear me say that I will never leave her. She don't give boys the eye. She will never make me jealous. Give me all the time as well as loving. Don't ask me why. She's a woman who loves a man. My love don't give me presents. I know that she's no peasant. Only ever have to give me love forever and forever. My love don't give me presents. Turn me on when I get lonely. People tell me that she's only. She is a
Our special guest, Steve Dean. Thank you, everybody, for watching. We'll see y'all down the road.